Hello everyone and welcome to Learn ISCA by Fun. Let's revise whatever we have done in the last four lectures. We started the chapter with the concept of enterprise governance. Enterprise governance was a set of practices and responsibilities exercised by the board and executive management to achieve objectives, manage risk and verify whether the organization resources are managed properly. Then enterprise governance was divided into two parts, that is corporate governance, also known as conformance, and business governance, also known as performance. Corporate governance was the system in which the enterprise was directed and controlled to achieve the objectives of increasing shareholders' value by enhancing the economic performance. And business governance was proactive in its approach and had a forward-looking view. It was business-oriented. This dimension mainly focused on the strategy and value creation with the objective of helping the board to make strategic direction and decisions. Then we moved on to benefits of governance. We learned the answer with the help of a small phrase also known as ADIPAI, which with each letter was starting with the initials of the each sentence. A was achieving the enterprise objectives, in which it ensured that the each element of mission and strategy was managed with a clear understanding and transparent decision rights and accountability framework. D was defining and encouraging the desired business behavior in the use of IT and in execution of IT outsourcing arrangements. I was implementing and integrating the desired business process into the business. P was providing stability and overcoming the limitations of the organization structure. I was improving customer business and internal relationship and satisfaction and reducing the internal territorial strife. E was enabling effective and strategically aligned decision making for IT principles that define the role of three, that is IT. Then we learned three portfolios, then IT investment and prioritization. Then we came on to IT governance and governance of enterprise IT. In the meaning of IT governance, we divided into two parts. That is mainly what do you mean by IT governance, and the second part was the objective. Sorry, the first part was the objective and second was the meaning of IT governance. The objective was to determine in costs and desired behavior and results to achieve the strategic impact of IT. And the objective and the meaning was of IT governance was, it is a system in which directors evaluate, direct and monitor the IT management to ensure effectiveness, accountability and compliance of IT. Then we moved on to benefits of IT governance. In benefits of IT governance, it contained two parts, mainly the 9 points of the benefits and the 6 points of the six other points which we had to ensure the criticality of the every benefit. The 9 benefits we divided into 3 parts, mainly increased value, user satisfaction, improved agility, management, transparency and compliances, then better IT and more optimal utilization of resources. And then for every defined benefit, it was critical to ensure that there were 6 points, mainly ownership, link, timing, risk, unambiguous measure, timely and accurate data for measure is available or easy to obtain. Then we came on to governance of enterprise IT. Governance of enterprise IT is a subset of corporate governance which facilitates implementation of framework of IS control in an enterprise encompassing all key areas. Then the primary objective of governance of enterprise IT was to analyze and articulate the requirements of GEIT. Then we came on to the second part of GEIT, that was the benefits. We learned it by a small short memory technique, that is CA goes to ITIT for legal and governance requirement. CA means consistent approach, IT means IT related decisions, second IT means IT related processes, legal and regulatory requirements which confirms the compliance, and governance requirement for the board members were met. The fifth point was whether the governance requirement for board members are met. Then we came on to the last part, that is the key governance practices of GEIT, which contained 3 subheadings, that is evaluate the governance system, direct the governance system and monitor the governance system. Each subhead was divided further into 3 subparts. In evaluate, we divided into identify, document and make judgment. in which identify the stakeholders, document the understanding of the requirements, and make judgment of the current and the future designing of the governance of enterprise IT. In direct the governance system, we divided the answer into three more parts, that is inform, guide, and define. Inform the leadership and obtain their commitment, buy-in, and support. Then guide structure, processes, practices for governance of IT. Define information requirement for informed decision making. In monitor the governance system, the three parts are monitor, assess, and provide. We had to monitor the economic and effectiveness and performance of the enterprise governance of IT. In assess, we have to assess that the governance system and implementation mechanism are operating effectively, and in provide, we had to provide the appropriate oversight of the IT. With this, we completed the whole governance system. Let's move on to the internal control as per COSO framework, which contains mainly, it contains five interrelated components, that is control environment, risk assessment, control activities, information and communication, and monitoring. With these five interrelated components containing in each organization, we could say that an enterprise has a good internal control system. Moving on to the first point, that is the control environment. We'll first read the text and then we'll try to learn. I've divided the whole answer into charts. You can draw the charts which I will further provide in the video. But I would suggest for this answer, make your own charts to make it very easy while reading just before the exams. Let's move on to the first point, that is control environment. This includes the elements that establish control context in which specific accounting system and control procedures must operate. For each business process, an organization needs to develop and maintain a control environment, including categorizing the criticality and materiality of each business process, plus the owners of business process. This is the chart for the control environment. If you want, you can pause the video and draw this chart, or you can make your own chart for the very ease of your own understanding. Control environment includes the elements which establishes control context in which specific accounting system and control procedures must operate. What elements do in control environment? They establish a control context in which specific accounting system and control procedures must operate. In control environment, there are certain elements which establishes a control context in which two things must operate, that is specific accounting system and control procedures. What do elements do? Establish control context in which specific accounting system and control procedures must operate. Then for each business, organization needs to develop and maintain a control environment, categorizing criticality and materiality into each business process and the owners of the business process. Every organization must have a control environment which categorizes the criticality and materiality of each business process along with the owners of the business process. Not only the business process, but the owners of the business process is also important in the control environment to have an effective internal control system in an organization. And the whole answer is like this. It includes element which establishes the control context in which specific accounting system and control procedures must operate. Each business process must develop and maintain a control environment, categorizing criticality and materiality of each business process plus owners of business process. Close this book and try to recall the answer. What does control environment do? What does the control environment have? It includes elements. What do elements do? Establish control context in which specific accounting system and control procedures must operate. For each business process, every organization must develop and maintain a control environment, categorizing criticality and materiality of each business process along with the owners of the business process. I hope you all understood this. Let's move on to the second point, that is risk assessment. Risk assessment. It includes elements that identify and analyze the risk faced by an organization and the way risk can be managed. Both internal and external auditors are concerned with the errors and irregularities that cause material loss to an organization. Each business process comes with various risks. A control environment must include an assessment of risk associated with each business process. Let's try to learn this answer. For this answer, I have also done a chart. You may copy the chart or you may draw your own chart. But remember, it must include these words. In risk assessment, there are certain elements. It includes elements that identify and analyze risk faced by an organization and the way risk can be managed. What does element in risk assessment do? They identify and analyze what the risk is faced, what an organization faces risk in the current situations, and the way how the risk is managed or how the risk can be managed. What do elements do? They identify and analyze risk faced by an organization and the way the risk can be managed. Then internal, every organization have an internal auditor and an external auditor. Their internal and external auditors are always concerned with the errors and regularities that cause a material loss for an organization. What are internal and external auditors concerned with? Errors and irregularities that may cause material loss for an organization. Each business process comes with various risks. Control environment must include assessment of risk and association with each business process. Each business process, there is no business process which does not have any risk. Every business process comes with a certain amount of risk. And hence, control environment should include assessment of risk. Assessment of risk associated with each business process. In risk assessment, we divided the whole answer into 3 points. First point, basically, it says that it includes elements which identify and analyze the risk faced by an organization and the way risk can be managed. Internal and external auditors are always concerned with errors and irregularities that may cause the material loss to an organization. Each business process comes with various risks. Control environment must include assessment of risk associated with each business process. What control environment must do? It should include assessment of risk which is associated with each business process. Let's do it for the last time. It includes elements that identify and analyze the risk faced by an organization and the way the risk can be managed. Internal and external auditors are always concerned with errors and irregularities that may cause material loss to an organization. Each business process comes with various risks. Control environment must include assessment of risk associated with each business process. I hope you all got that. Let's move on to the third point. Third point is control activities. First was control environment. Second was risk assessment. Third is control activities. It includes elements that operate to ensure transactions are authorized, duties are segregated, adequate documentation and records are maintained, assets and records are safeguarded, independent check on performance and valuation of records. Thus, these are called accounting controls. Internal auditors are also concerned with admin controls to achieve effectiveness and efficiency of objectives. Control activities must be developed to manage, mitigate and reduce the risk associated with each business process. It is unrealistic to expect to eliminate risk completely. Let's try to learn this answer. What elements are included in control activities? It includes elements that operate to ensure that transactions are authorized, duties are segregated, adequate documents and records are maintained, assets and records are safeguarded, independent check on performance, and valuation of the records. In control activities, the elements operate to ensure 6 points, mainly transaction duties, adequate assets, independent and valuation. Try to make a combination of first words, whichever I have underlined, that is transaction duties are adequate, assets independent valuation, so that you will be able to remember it. What elements do that operate to ensure that transactions are authorized, duties are segregated, adequate documents and records are maintained. 3 points are divided into first three and the next three. Transaction duties adequate, transactions are authorized, duties are segregated, and adequate documents and records are maintained. Then the next 3 points are assets independent and valuation. Assets and records are safeguarded, independent check on performance and valuation of records. What are the 6 points? Transactions, duties, adequate, assets, independent, valuation. Transactions are authorized, duties are segregated, adequate document and records are maintained, assets and records are safeguarded, independent check on performance and valuation of the records. In control activities, the elements include, they operate to ensure the 6 points. I hope you all got that. These 6 points, whichever we have read, which the elements operate to ensure, these are also known as accounting controls. Internal auditors are also concerned with admin controls. These internal controls form part of the internal controls. But along with this, the internal auditors are also concerned with admin controls to achieve the effectiveness and efficiency of the objectives. Then control activities must be developed to manage, mitigate and reduce risk associated with each business process. What control activity must do? Control activities must be developed to manage, mitigate and reduce the risk associated with each business process. It is unrealistic to eliminate the risk completely. As we all know that each business process comes with certain amount of risk, there will be no business process where risk will not be there. And hence, control activities must be developed in such a way that it should manage, mitigate and reduce the risk associated with each business process. It is unrealistic to eliminate the risk completely. I hope you all got that. What were the points in control activities? It includes elements which operate to ensure the 6 points. What are the 6 points? Transactions, duties, adequate, assets, independent, valuation. Transactions are authorized, duties are segregated, adequate documents and records are maintained, assets and records are safeguarded, independent check on performance and valuation of records. These are called accounting controls, but internal auditors are also concerned with the second controls, that are admin controls. Why they are concerned? To achieve the effectiveness and efficiency of objectives. Then control activities must be developed in such a way to manage, mitigate and reduce the risk associated with each business process, but it is unrealistic to eliminate risk completely. And with this, we completed the 3 points. First point was control environment, second was risk assessment, third was control activities. Let's move on to the fourth point, that is information and communication system. Information and communication system. These are the elements in which information is identified, captured and exchanged in a timely and appropriate form to allow personnel to discharge their responsibilities. These are associated with control activities regarding information and communication system of entity that acts as one of the component of internal accounting system. These enable an organization to capture and exchange the information needed to conduct and manage the control its business processes. What elements in information and communication system do? In this system, information is identified and captured. whatever the information is will be there, it will be identified and captured, and it will be exchanged with the proper personnel there in timely and appropriate form to allow the personnel to discharge their responsibilities. What will elements do in this information and communication? They will capture the information, they will first identify the information and then capture it. The captured information will then be transferred in timely and appropriate form to allow the personnel to discharge their responsibilities. What will elements do? They will identify the information and capture it. They will timely and exchange them in an appropriate form to allow the personnel discharge their responsibilities. What was the second point? Information and communication are associated with control activities. Information communication system of an entity acts as one of the component of internal accounting system. Information is very crucial in an organization. It should be timely and accurately available at the time to discharge the responsibilities by the personnel. We read that in earlier point. And it is so closely associated with the control activities that it forms the as one of the important component of the internal accounting system. Hence, the second point is that information and communication is associated with the control activities. Information and communication system of an entity acts as one of the component of internal accounting system. Then the third point is, these enable an organization to capture and exchange information needed to conduct, manage and control the business process. Why information is needed? Why it is captured and exchanged? To conduct, manage and control the business process. What does information and communication do? These enable an organization to capture and exchange whatever the information is needed to conduct, manage and control the business process. What was the first point? The elements in the information and communication system. They identify the information and capture it and exchange them in timely and in accurate form so that personnel can be discharged their responsibilities timely. Then it is associated with the control activities. Information and communication system of an entity forms an important component of internal accounting system. These enable an organization to capture and exchange information needed to conduct, manage and control the business process. With this, the fourth point is also complete. Let's move on to the last and the fifth point, that is monitoring. The fifth point is monitoring. The internal control process must be continuously monitored with modification made as warranted by the changing conditions. This includes the elements that ensure internal control operates reliably over the time. The best internal controls are worthless if they are not monitored and changes are not made when they are not working. In monitoring, internal control processes should be continuously monitored with modifications as warranted by the changing conditions. Internal control process should be continuously monitored, otherwise the internal control, whichever the best internal control system you have applied, it will be a fail. Hence, it should be continuously monitored with frequent modifications as warranted by the changing conditions. Why internal control process should be continuously monitored? So that it should always be up to date and it should never fail. It should be continuously monitored with modifications as warranted by the changing conditions. It includes elements that ensure internal control operates reliably over the time. Why it should be monitored? So that the internal control operates reliably over the time. And best internal controls are worthless if not monitored and changes are not made when things are not working. As I already said before, you apply best of the best internal control system, but if you don't monitor or don't make modifications on time, then it will be worthless. It will be a fail system. Hence, it should be continuously monitored with modifications It includes elements that ensure internal control operates reliably over the time. Best internal controls are worthless if not monitored, and changes are not made when they are not working. I hope you all got the 5 points of internal control system as provided by the COSO framework. The first point was control environment. Second point, risk assessment. Third point, control activities. Fourth point, internal and information communication system. And fifth point is monitoring. What does control environment include? It includes elements which establishes the control context in which specific accounting system and control procedures must operate. For each business process, organization needs to develop and maintain control environment, categorizing the criticality and materiality of each business process along with the owners of the business process. Then we read the risk assessment, which included the elements which identify the risk faced by an organization and the way risk can be managed. Internal auditors and external auditors both are concerned with the errors and irregularities which would cause the material loss to an organization, and hence each business process comes with various risks. Control environment should include assessment of risk associated with each business process. Then the third point was control activities, which included element which ensures 6 points, mainly transactions, duties, adequate, assets, independent, and valuation. Transactions are authorized, duties are segregated, adequate documentation and records are maintained, assets and records are safeguarded, independent check on performance, and valuation of records. These are also called accounting controls, but internal auditors are also concerned with admin controls to achieve effectiveness and efficiency of the objectives. Control activities must be developed to manage, mitigate, and reduce the risk, as each business process comes with certain amount of risk, and it is completely unrealistic to eliminate the risk. Then we came on to the fourth point, that is information and communication system. In this, it included the elements which identifies the information and captures it. It identifies the information and captures it and exchange in timely and appropriate form to allow the personnel to discharge their responsibilities. Then the second point was it is associated with the control activities. Information and communication system of an entity acts as one of the important component of internal accounting system. These enable an organization to capture and exchange information required and conduct and manage, control the business process. Then we came on to the fifth point, that is monitoring. In this, internal control process should be continuously monitored with modification as warranted by the changing conditions. It includes elements that ensure internal control operates reliably over the time, and best internal controls are worthless if not monitored or changes are not made when they are not working. We'll not stop here. And in the next video, we will do IT steering committee. Till then, it's a goodbye and thank you.